Hi friends, welcome back to Freshers World YouTube channel Jobs and Careers. Today we will solve 2018 IBPS PO Prelims quiz. Let's begin. A, B and C, each working alone, can finish a piece of work in 27, 33 and 45 days respectively. A starts by working alone for 12 days, then B takes over from A and works for 11 days. At this stage, C takes over from B and completes the remaining work. In how many days the whole work was completed? So C worked for remaining days, so we can take C worked for X days. So here it is given that A can complete the work in 27 days. So the work done by A in 1 day equals 1 by 27. Similarly, B equals 1 by 33 and C equals 1 by 45. It's given that A worked for 12 days. So work done by A equals 12 by 27. That is 12 into 1 by 27. Similarly, B equals 11 by 33. And C equals X by 45. We know that A, B and C together completed the work. So the part of work done by A is 12 by 27, B is 11 by 33 and C is X by 45. Summing up all this, we get the value 1. A plus B plus C equals 12 by 27 plus 11 by 33 plus X by 45 equals 1, which implies upon reducing it to the lowest form we get 4 by 9 plus 1 by 3 plus X by 45 equals 1. Making the denominator same, we get 20 plus 15 plus x by 45 equals 1. 35 plus x equals 45. X equals 45 minus 35 and that equals 10. So C worked for 10 days. We need to find the total days needed to complete. That is 12 plus 11 plus 10, 33 days. Sonal's age 4 years hence will be equal to Radhika's age 5 years ago. If the respective ratio between Radhika's present age and Komal's present age is 3:2 and Komal's present age is 22 years, what is Sonal's present age? Here it's given that Komal's age is 22 years and Radhika's and Komal's present age ratio is 3:2. Therefore, Radhika's present age equals 22 into 3/2. That equals 33 years. It's given that Sonal's age 4 years hence and Radhika's age 5 years ago is equals. So let Sonal's present age be X. Then from the question we know that X plus 4 equals 33 minus 5, which implies X equals 28 minus 4. That equals 24 years. Next question. Self gave 25% of her monthly salary to her mother. From the remaining salary, she paid 50% towards rent and 25% she kept aside for her monthly expenses. The remaining amount she kept in bank account. The sum of The amount she kept in the bank and that she gave to her mother was rupees 42,000. What was her monthly salary? So her total salary, let it be 100%, be X. 25% of this she gave to her mother. Of the remaining, so 100 minus 25, of 75%, 15% she used towards rent and 25% kept aside for monthly expense. The remaining amount she kept in bank account. The sum of the amount she kept in bank. Amount kept in bank. The amount she gave her mother equals rupees 42,000. What is the salary? 25% of the total salary is given to her mother, and of the remaining 75%, 15% was used for rent and 25% was kept aside for expenses. So that is 15 plus 25, 40%. 40% of 75% was used for rent and expenses. Rest of the amount she kept in bank. 60% of 75% was kept in bank. So this plus amount which she gave her mother, 25% equals rupees 42,000. 25 by 100 into x plus, since we have taken salary as x, 60% of 75% of x equals 42,000. It is 25x by 100 plus 60 by 100 into 75, 3 by 4x equals 42,000. 1 by 4x plus 3 by 5 into 3 by 4x equals 42,000. So that is 1 by 4x plus 9 by 20x equals 42,000. That implies 5x plus 9x by 20 equals 42,000, which implies 5 plus 9, 14x by 20 equals 42,000. That implies 7 by 10x equals 42,000. X equals 42,000 into 10 by 7. That equals 60,000. So the total salary equals rupees 60,000. A triangle has two of its angle in the ratio 1:2. If the measure of one of its angle is 30 degree, what is the measure of the largest angle of the triangle in degrees? So considering one angle be 30 degree, then we know that two angles are in the ratio 1:2. So if one angle is 30 degree, the next can be 60 degree. We know that the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So 30 degree plus 60 degree plus x equals 180 degree, which implies x equals 180 degree minus 90 degree, that equals 90 degree. So we get x equals 90 degree. So considering another case, and if we take the second angle to be 30 degree, then first angle be 15 degree. So we get 15 degree and 30 degree. We need to find the third angle. So 15 plus 30 plus x equals 180 degree. So x equals 180 degree minus 45 degree, that equals 135 degree. So x can be 135 degree. We know that two angles are in the ratio 1 is to 2. So let the angles be 1x and 2x. So x plus 2x plus 30 degree equals 180 degree. That is 3x plus 30 degree equals 180 degree. 3x equals 150. X equals 50 degree. So the angles will be 50 degree, 100 degree, and 30 degree. So the highest angle will be 100 degree. So when we solve this equation, this question in different ways, we get the value. And when this question was asked, all these three options were given separately as different options. One option was 90 degree, next was 135, next was 100, fourth option was cannot be determined, and last was none of this. So when such questions come, we have to choose based on the options given. So since all these three answers were given as separate options, for this question we have to go with cannot be determined. Otherwise, based on the option, choose the answer. Hope you all have understood the questions. So if you have any doubts regarding the explanations, please do comment below. And if you found this video useful, please like the video. And for more videos, please subscribe to our channel. Good luck with your preparation. Thank you.